Okay, class, today we're going to learn about triangles. Can anyone tell me a type of triangle? Sarah?
Equilateral triangle.
And do you know what that is?
So all three sides are the same.
Okay, can you tell me which one of these triangles up here is the equilateral?
That one.
This one?
Yep.
Yes. Okay, can anyone tell me another type of triangle? Kelsey?
Isosceles.
And do you know what that is?
The one to the left of.
This one?
Yeah.
And do you know what makes an isosceles triangle?
Two sides are the same length.
Okay. And the last type of triangle? Elise?
A right triangle. And it's the one all the way to the left because it has a right angle.
Yes. So all three types of triangles have three angles and they all add up to 180 degrees. So if we look at the equilateral triangle, since all three sides are the same length, all three angles have to be the same. So if there are three angles and it's 180 degrees in the triangle, how much is each angle equal? Sarah?
60 degrees.
Right. Okay, so if we move to the isosceles triangle, Elise, what does that square mean again?
It means it's a right angle.
And how many degrees does that mean?
90.
Okay. So, if we look inside the isosceles triangle, where this dotted line is, it's the same as a right triangle. So two right triangles make up an isosceles triangle. So, if this angle up here is 30 degrees, how much would each one of these angles be?
60.
And how did you come up with that answer?
Because 30 plus 60 equals 90, and 90 plus 90 equals
180. Okay, it'll be the same thing for the right triangle. So if this one was 30, this one would also be 60. So now if we use this one, and this side is equal to this side, that means both of these angles would be the same. So if we have one 90 degree angle, what are the other two? Kelsey?
45.
Yes. So another unique thing for right triangles is called the Pythagorean theorem. So a squared plus b squared equals c squared. So if we take this triangle right here, our hypotenuse, which is the longest side of any triangle, is always going to be c. So this is the hypotenuse, this one, and this one. So this only works for right triangles, so you couldn't use it for an equilateral triangle because all three sides are the same length. So a and b go opposite of the hypotenuse. So if we label this one A, this one B, and this one C, we can figure out the lengths of all three sides. So we know that A is equal to 3, and C is equal to 5. Can someone come up here and show me how to do the Pythagorean theorem? Sarah?
So A is 3, so you can plug it in here, and be squared. Then we don't know the B, and C would be 5 squared, right? So we do 3 squared, that's 9. We still don't know B squared, and 5 squared is 25. Now, we need to get